I thank the gentleman. Congressman Connolly.
Thank you, Madam Chairman, and welcome, Secretary Paulson. Thank you for your patience today, given our schedule. I'd like to go back just a little bit, and maybe I could start following up on my colleague's question about the MAC. It's our understanding that not once but twice, Mr. Lewis threatened to invoke the MAC because they had discovered a $12 billion problem in the Merrill Lynch deal. Is that correct?
Well, what I remembered was 18 billion pre-tax at one time and then 22 billion pre-tax at the end and 15 billion after tax. But my numbers might be wrong.
Okay. But in both cases, they threatened or discussed with you the possibility of invoking the MAC. Is that correct?
Yes.
And your reaction, obviously negative in both instances, why?
It was based upon the view of very experienced lawyers, and again, I haven't heard this refuted elsewhere with any degree of vehemence, that there was a legally binding contract and that the MAC clause would not have been legally valid in this situation. The shareholders had voted in both companies. This was a Delaware company.
But that's really a legal matter, obviously not normally involving the Secretary of Treasury. Why would you care one way or the other whether he was acting on misinformation, legal misinformation, and threatening to invoke the MAC?
I normally wouldn't care, but this is... But if you have a situation where a company in doing something like this in a period of uncertainty and fear could do grave damage in the opinion of their regulator to that company and to the whole system, I sure better care.
You were worried about the impact on a very fragile system at that time.
Yeah, I was worried about the impact on the very practical system and also the impact on B of A, which was the biggest bank.
Given that concern, Mr. Secretary, at any time in that period in around December of 2008, did you have any conversation that could be construed explicitly or impliedly as promising in exchange for their backing off the MAC threat or even going public with the $12 billion or whatever the ultimate number was, in exchange for that silence or that proceeding forward, that there would be TARP funding available to Mr. Lewis and BOA?
We definitely had conversations, but it wasn't in exchange for. No matter what they did, I felt a responsibility. I know Ben Bernanke felt the responsibility to keep the financial system from collapsing. So this was not a situation where, gee, we'll do this big favor for you. This was a situation where we were doing this for the American people.
Right.
And it just so happened that there was an alignment of interest because B of A failure wouldn't have been good for the B of A shareholders either.
And this alignment of interest, as you know, and you've heard ad nauseum here today, Mr. Lewis construed as almost a threat by you and perhaps by Mr. Bernanke, that if you didn't take the federal money, we're going to fire you and your board. That's a far cry from how you characterize it as sort of a confluence of interest.
Well, no, I didn't. There's two different things, okay? The confluence of interest was just what I said, which was we certainly didn't want B of A to be unstable. In terms of my communication with him, I've been pretty direct. I wouldn't use the word threat, but I've said what I said, and I was very direct, and I intended to give a very direct, strong, clear message, and that was, I'm not characterizing it as a threat, because, and Lewis didn't characterize it as a threat, but I did explain the Fed's powers. But that was in terms of the confluence of interest, to me, that's just an obvious thing. If you follow the train of logic we've laid out here, you either accept the logic or you don't. I mean, some people will say, well, there was no crisis, nothing would have happened to B of A, nothing would have happened to Merrill Lynch, nothing would happen to the financial system. I can't satisfy those people.
Yes, and I'm with you, Mr. Secretary. There was a crisis, and I understand where you and the Federal Reserve Chairman were coming from, but I guess we're trying to understand, and I see my time is up, Madam Chairman. I hope I have the opportunity to return to some specific questions regarding the terms, conditions of the agreement to go forward with TARP funding. Thank you.
I thank the gentleman. Mr. Schacht?